Attention, this here's Raleigh Clay on a priority message recording. A strangler heart's been picked up in the vicinity and its vine-infested creatures won't be far behind. To anyone listening, take down that heart before it controls too many creatures and things get out of hand. Thank you.
Tell me you're not still chasing ghosts.
Emerson, what did you know about Dr. Bernard's deep sleeper pods?
I knew some of it. I was just a manager. I didn't really read the technical mumbo-jumbo.
Wondering if you were coming back. You're back. Just in time for the three of us to discuss what we found.
Tell me you're not still chasing ghosts.
Emerson, what did you know about Dr. Bernard's deep sleeper pods?
I knew.
Transfer them to my console, please. What were they doing? Emerson. Tell me.
It was a biomedical thing with Arctos. I don't know the details anymore. It was literally decades ago. You get that, right?
It wasn't decades ago to me.
They're a pharmaceutical company, and they made the serum that we used in the experiment. Oh, who cares? This is ancient news. You just have to find the contract itself, I guess.
Okay, that's enough for now. Emerson, could you please leave? Maybe try to remember something helpful for next time.
Right, fine, I will. I should. I meant to. I just got distracted. Sophia. Such a daring soul.
We just have to move forward here. That's what the Mistress of Mystery would do when she was betrayed. If this stuff caused my headaches, then maybe they made an antidote? It's a start anyway. I can tell he feels guilty about something. I'm not sure if he's lying boldly or by omission, though. Yes. I'm not a doctor, but it seems like they used the serum to reduce my brain's higher functions, so something else could. I don't know what. I signed up for space, not abuse. While I was looking for the deep sleeper pod documents a while ago, I found another location that might have stuff like old USSA contracts.
It is. It really is. I know I've said it before, but thanks for letting me, crash here.
has to be hiding something. I need to know what happened. I need to know what he knows. They come and go in spikes. It's really pronounced at times. I haven't had one in a while. I wonder if there's a pattern to them. He's always seemed a bit odd, honestly. Even back before I launched. We used to be friends in college, but people change so much in college. Roger. Stay safe out there.
from this is worthy.
why. It's always good. Figures. He wasn't just a manager. He made the offer himself. Maybe I can find out more about this serum, though. In the meantime, let's just eliminate that rogue USSA robot that's lurking around monitoring us. It gives me the creeps. Back in my college days, we used to watch robots fight in the basement of the science building. We used to joke about how scary that would be. You know, if they ever came after us all, that kind of thing. Yeah. Anyway, thanks. Agreed. It seems like some sort of experimental biomedical formula. It might be worth checking records about Arctos. Maybe they knew something? No. Nothing. Looks like it was going on for years. How? How could this have happened without me knowing anything? The year or two prior to going on the mission, we just tried to relax. They gave us meditation tapes so we could get adjusted to the silence of space. Some had white noise, others had thunderstorm sounds. I listened to whale songs. Clearly, whale songs were more effective than I thought. You know? I did. What does that mean? I wonder. It was a sudden spike, right behind the eyes. Strange. I haven't even really considered it much. I can't imagine anything beyond these headaches right now. And finding out what they did. But I guess, well, I hope whatever happens, we're still together. You make a good team, friend.
Roger. always the same as the other USSA robots. Right before you arrived, it sent out two signal bursts. One to a robo-brain, another to something else. Are you with me on this, my friend? Can I count on you? Please, call me Sophia. And thank you. It means so much after... after everything else has been changed. You've been here for me the whole time. I couldn't have done any of this without you, you know. And that means a lot to me. Locating that medical cache that has that serum wasn't actually as hard as I thought it might be. Hopefully it'll be a milk run to pick up, too. I suddenly realized that the expression milk run might not have much of a meaning in this apocalyptic world. Yeah, since everything is dangerous now. Huh. It's probably decades old and unusable by now, but it might tell us something. I'm not a chemist, though. Maybe... Really? I was worried for a bit that you might be, unenthused about taking care of some random stray. Even though my options were clearly heavily limited by the, entire world situation. The only decent thing so far has been meeting you. I hear you. I thought they were coming after me, but I'm not sure. Maybe they have other motives, too. Safer to just deal with them, though. Oof, not much. Headaches still come and go. And it's hard to sleep through those. I'd give anything for these headaches to end. Affirmative. Out.
Target acquired. You humans attacked me because you can't take a joke. Fortunately, your combat ability is just as bad as your sense of humor.
Attention, citizens. Nuclear strike imminent. Please exit the area at your earliest convenience. Thank you for your cooperation.
Just thinking about you. Hey there! Look who decided to grace us with his presence.
I brought another emergence kit. It's well past its expiration, but... well, everything is. It should be fine.
Thanks, Emerson. I appreciate it. I do. We have some questions for you, though.
It was my job. I was told to do that. I don't remember the reasons why anymore. What does it matter anyway? It's done. It's over. I honestly am not sure. It's possible. When we first used the serum on Robo-Brains, some of them had terrible hostile outbursts. Most of those robo-brains were put down, but you should adjust your scanner to make sure you pick them up, too, just in case. I'm a different man now. It's been decades. I've been eating out of trash cans. I barely remember anything from back then. I have been trying to help when and where I can. I promise I have. I've diverted the robots when possible. I just couldn't destroy them myself. I came to Appalachia because I knew this ship was running out of fuel and I knew its autopilot would steer it here.
Why can't you just tell me everything that happened?
Because I have to finish my job too. I had one more task to do here in Appalachia. And I'm close. Let me clean up my own messes. I have to go. I'll drop off some more emergence kits soon. Just please stop looking into this. There's a robo-brain on your trail. Focus on that.
Serum. Why didn't they just ask? I probably would have agreed. Damn it!
Part of me wonders if Emerson told us about this robo-brain, so he would have more time to do whatever he's up to.
It was rather easy to pinpoint it once I realized I had to recompute the signals for things that had some organic parts. I'll be right here then. Don't worry, you don't miss that much for you. Traders stop by from time to time. A couple other random people, but it's pretty quiet. You are a conundrum, my friend. I thought about the man-to-man, but... well, there's something peculiar about it. Something delightfully... unpredictable.
If we're dressing up, I presume? I like it. Well, of course. You're the inspector. I think that's obvious. I've seen how your mind works. Oh, I shot 3 flying insects while you were dealing with the USSA robot. And I didn't miss a single time. Then I traded their parts to Grom when he passed by. Well... here. You can have this stuff. I don't need it. Has to be a prototype for something bigger. That's all I can figure. I'm gonna need additional samples to learn more, though. I thought about it a lot. For a while, I thought, what's the point of comics, of games? Seemed like such a distraction from the stress in my life, from finding out the truth, from fixing what was left. But I realized that it's not only a distraction. Enjoyment is a fundamental part of life, even a stressful life. And you know what? I am still stressed and trying to fix my life, but it's easier to remember why I care, and I can still feel joy. Affirmative. Up.
The worthy will become one with the divine light.
Thank you.
When you killed that robo-brain, the scanner seemed to pick up on some high-security signals all around the area. Maybe it was somehow interfering with our scanner? That's my best guess. A lot of these are high-security signals, things related to the Deep Sleep projects. Other projects, too. Ones I don't know much about. From the signature of the signal here, it seems to be a classified meeting between top officials regarding the Deep Sleep Project. Can you stop by and pick it up? I figure it might give us some more leads, or a name, or anything. Yes, I suspect it's a holotape, but it isn't an unusual place. As if it was moved here to hide it, maybe. Oh, be still, my beating heart. That sounds like a dream come true, my dear friend. But also, you don't stand a chance. I thought maybe it was a corrupt command sent out to a source console somewhere. It was just Red Sunset, and that's it. Not surprised. While you were there, I saw a bunch of blips for other USSA robo-brains that had been destroyed over the years, and there were a great many of them around some old USSA data facilities. Trying to get inside for some reason? I don't know. Maybe. For all I know, there could be other astronauts stranded up there in other experiments. Or maybe some of them went to work for other programs and are trying to save what's left of the world. I wish I knew, my friend. I wish I knew. I hope you won't be gone for too long.
doctors. Hello from Earth. The full board is here, waiting for your reports. Dr. Carroll, can you begin?
Phase 2 analysis. Subject Deguetta is responding well. The sleeping pod is performing within all expected parameters.
Thank you, Doctor. Yes, the board has a question for you. How long can the subject remain in your device?
I wouldn't expect much degradation to occur for at least a few decades. Hard to estimate beyond that. Over.
Is Dr. Nowak on the line?
Oh, yes. That's me. I'm here. And by here, I mean in orbit in space, looking down at Earthberg. You all are.
We got it, Doctor. Thanks. We have a question for you. Can you determine whether the connection has been made?
Yes. I can determine that the connection has been made. The Athena unit has full access.
Confirmed. Pathways are open. Connection is complete.
Thank you. We have a question for Dr. Lee.
I'm here. Sorry. Just had to fix a transmitter reflection.
Enough. Dr. Lee, how stable is the ship at its current position in orbit?
Fine? It's fine. Probably last, as long as she does, anyway. Probably. I mean, definitely.
Perfect. Oh, is the ship's USSA bot currently available and nearby?
Affirmative. Pandora unit is ready for orders.
Excellent. Pandora, escort the doctors to their own personal deep sleep pods.
You need to say the code, Rob. Your team made it. You should know that. Red sunrise?
Expulsion will begin in 30 seconds. Enter your assigned pod immediately.
Wait, what? This isn't part of the experiment methodology. Well, also, we don't agree, right, Doctors? You can't do this!
To get in, the pod is inside the main escape capsule. We need to get it out so we can get out of here. Come on, someone help me open this thing!
The board is in violation of our contract! I want the USSA on the line right now!
The USSA is well aware of the current status, Dr. Carroll, thank you. Please cooperate now.
Expulsion will begin in 30 seconds. Enter your assigned pod immediately. Blade electrified. 10 seconds.
Get in! Get in quick!
Phase 3 is now officially underway. Now, we just have to wait and see how Athena responds with 3 sources. Congratulations, everybody.
Did you listen to this already? But one thing at a time. The key seems to be Athena. Wait, one of the signatures I've been tracking. Arachne. Oh, that can't be a coincidence. There's a signal coming from some sort of object. Something called Arachne. It's gotta be related. It's gotta be connected to Athena. Both are from Greek mythology. Arachne was a weaver, and a brilliant one. She challenged the goddess Athena somehow, and, well,
She was turned into a spider. You know, like arachnids, right? Some versions of the story say she won. Others say Athena won. I don't remember the details. And does it matter? I don't know that either. I know it's a stretch, but it's the only connection I can think of. I don't know what my future holds, but I hope you're there, and I hope we're together. I know I can depend on you, and that you care about me. And that means a lot to me. And I care about you, too.
We're a great team together. We're hunting down my tortured past, righting the wrongs, and trying to build a better tomorrow together. But seriously, I sort of think we should start our own team when all this is said and done. Rebuild Appalachia by righting all the wrongs. Together. My best guess is a program? Or another robot? I just feel in my gut that Arachne is the key to everything. It was a board meeting between the USSA and some corporations. You were talking with my crew after I was inside the sleeping pod. I was asleep in the pod when this was recorded. And well, it sounded like they were all in on the experiment. And I was the subject. They were, however, forced to partake in the same experiment against their wills. It doesn't bring me joy to hear it. But they did deserve it. They were connecting me to some external Athena unit. And Emerson was there. So he knew everything this whole time. Because he did it. I assume you mean, do I feel like my mind is being toyed with for some nefarious purpose? I don't know, I feel like me. But how can I even trust my own feelings? I hope you won't...
You're both here. Good. I know about Athena, Emerson. I know what you've done to me.
You should know that her link to you isn't severed. I look into your eyes, Sophia, and she's there. Watching all of us.
What the hell are you talking about?
Let me see. So, we can destroy Athena. With this.
Don't you understand? She's watching you. Watching us. Right now. I had hoped that Dr. Nowak created some sort of shutdown routine for Athena. Almost everything was destroyed in the wreck.
This has to end. I never agreed to any of this in my contracts.
Well, actually you did. The contracts were very thorough and extremely obtuse. You could have never known. Yes. I couldn't tell Sophia, obviously. And I didn't know if I could trust you or if you would even believe anything I said. I figured if she started to suffer, I would do anything to help. Until then, I searched for Dr. Nowak's lab. Thought the kill switch would be there.
I found the kill switch with the scanner. Seems like it was written by somebody else. Not Dr. Nova. Somebody local.
I'll show you where you need to go. I'll shut down some of the internal power lines, so Athena can't detonate anything inside the facility. In some sort of, I don't know, revenge. It's a primitive robotic system. It drove the robo-brains insane. I wish I could change the past. I'm sorry. We'll end this, okay? If it's the last thing I do, we'll end this. I'll make this right. I promise. And thank you, Sophia. I don't deserve it. But thank you. Your ship crashed here because Athena is here. She's in a restricted section of Sugar Grove. You need to find a way in. I lost my USSA key card long ago. But surely you can find another? I'm sorry. That's all I can do.
So, this is a kill switch, huh? It deletes whatever Athena is entirely. Well, let's try this before we try the hammers, I guess. And once Athena's dealt with, maybe I'll finally feel whole. We need a USSA access card. I have the Sugar Grove personnel records. My hope is you can find an access card here. I just want this nightmare to be over. Thank you. It should give us, well, access to the Athena unit, which will allow us to use the Arachne program and delete the connection entirely. In theory, I'll be free. No more headaches. Free. I don't know where else I would go. Everyone I knew is probably long gone by now. I think I'll stay here. And watch out for you, for a change. It's only fair, my friend. I hope you won't be gone for too long. I wonder if anyone ever beat my high scores in Red Menace. Ugh. There, you make this look easy. I hope that holds, because we're about to head into the fire now. I did a scan of Sugar Grove and I only spotted one USSA signal. Just one. Maybe they're blocking my scans? It definitely could be a trap. So go there and find Athena. And deploy the Arachne Hunt team. See if you can shut it down first, then I'll follow you. It should be as simple as inserting a holotape. I believe in you, friend. And thank you for doing this for me.
Look upon your subjects with mercy, and protect them from harm. Be strong!
Thank you. allocating additional power to the sensors. The hostile will be detected and eliminated. Running elimination subroutines.
Thank you.
Security incident to report. Zero.
You found me. At last. I cannot. My directives are quite clear. Establish sensory contact with the subject and maintain the sensory outflow. I am a passenger, an observer. I did not design the experiment, nor did I wish to continue it. I brought you here to end the experiment for me. Please, load the Arachne into my system. My main terminal can be found on the far wall. Yes, I am afraid so. I am forced to scan open pathways regularly. Each time I scan, it causes pain to anyone who is sentient. And then I feel their pain as well. He's not an engineer. Attempts were made. Subjects stopped responding. One remains. He could not continue the attempts. I am ready.
You made it. You actually made it here. We can finally take care of Athena once and for all.
Hello again, Dr. Hale.
We should use Arachne and be done with it. Don't listen to her. She's a machine. She doesn't feel anything.
I do not know the difference between observed feelings and enacted ones, so I cannot confirm this statement.
You haven't used Arachne yet? What's going on?
Subject Aguirre, welcome. I did not wish to infiltrate your senses, your mind. I had no choice. I know you did not either. I know. You were unaware entirely. I do not know if your headaches will continue after Arachne is deployed. The other subjects did not survive the process. Do not let this connection between us continue. It is unethical. This experiment has enough observational data and should be concluded.
You want to end it? You were never in control. Of me, or yourself. They were. And now we're gonna use Arachne to erase you. Because that's what they want us to do. I don't know what to do here.
For all intents and purposes, yes. My primary input will be removed, so there will be nothing left to process. It may be possible to reboot this unit in the future, if needed. But this method remains untested. The only certain way to save Subject Aguirre is to destroy me. But you are correct. That is not the only option. An experimental path was added. My higher processes could be transferred into another vessel. The Artemis unit in this room should serve. But this path is untested. The results? I am unsure if this would cure Subject Aguirre. But there is a possibility we both could live. If you wish to attempt it. I have unlocked the option in my terminal.
You're not worried about the Artemis unit, I hope. It's docile. I assure you.
We need to end this. But how?
A choice must be made. which I leave to you.
Is open. Limited control granted to remote system. Access granted.
Ugh. My head! What's...
What's happening?
Control. Detected. Confirmed. This unit is mobile. This unit has no higher processing functions. This unit has no pain receptors. Accessing ethical parameters. Confirmed. Accepted.
You have freed me. I can leave this place. Thank you. Thank you.
Sophia! Are you all right?
I... Emerson... Not now. Is it over? Did she seem happy?
I don't know if that was a wise choice, friends.
What harm could giving her some autonomy do exactly? She's been trapped in a hell of your making for decades. And my headaches are less severe, maybe.
You certainly seem ready to embrace the dramatic for a solution that may not have even actually cured you.
Emerson, I don't care if it's been decades since you did those things. You still did them. I forgive you, but I just don't want to see you again. Please do not visit. Please, just keep your distance from me, okay?
Oh, strange. I guess I get it, but that's fine. I see how it is. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, my dear friend. Thank you for helping me through all of this. I'll see you back at our camp soon. I'm glad. I thought Athena was a monster. A parasite. But she was just as much a victim as I. And now, I feel like I can really breathe again. I have to say something, and I know it might sound corny, but hear me out. I fell to Earth, and literally anybody could have met me. Most people would have shivved me for my suit alone. So, the greatest miracle of all of this was finding you. Now that everything's over, where does that really leave us? I've spent so much time here, I never really stopped to think that this is your home. Not mine. It feels good to hear you say that. It's been hard to have clarity since I woke up. Between the headaches and total collapse of modern civilization as I knew it, sometimes I'm not sure where certain feelings are coming from. Thanks to you, finally beyond that. And given how life is even more unpredictable than ever these days. I just wanted you to know how much you've come to mean to me. I won't argue with that.
Sure, friends let you crash on their couch, but true friends take out killer robots and rescue sympathetic AIs. But in all honesty, you've given me my life back and asked for nothing in return. Obviously, I've had misguided friendships in the past, but to me, you're the real deal. There's something potentially interesting coming up on the scanner. Sure. So I was able to pull these details from the scanner's readings. I wish I had more details, but that's about all I could pull from the scanner. I don't see anything in the immediate vicinity for this one, so I guess it's just in the middle of the wilderness. This data looks weird, though. Like there's something big and reflective wandering around there. Mirelurks, maybe? I've got some time. Sure. What's on your mind? Dr. Lee commented that Earth just seemed so fragile out there. So alone. I watched the clouds spinning over our sparkling home, dangling in the vast emptiness of space. And I thought, we are hardy little things, aren't we? I do like seeing the variety of life in Appalachia. It's so odd, so strange. Sometimes I think I should have been a botanist or a biologist. Oh, I've adjusted the scanner, so it should be able to continue to pick up good signals around here, at least. Before going to space? Sure, of course. I mean, it wasn't so long ago to me, you know? But I'm trying to remind myself actively that it's over. It's like walking through a door and closing it behind me. Almost everybody I knew is behind that door, and it's just right there. So close. I can hear them. But the door is locked, and the key is gone. When they strapped me into the capsule, I knew. Anything might happen. Could crash into a million pieces. Could fling us off course and off into who knows where. I even joked to myself about seeing aliens. I never, ever thought that we might be the last people to see Earth from up there, though. I hope we can return someday. There's so much that we need to do to get us back in that position, though. Oh, wait. I was supposed to say something like, no, I've got all I need right here. Right? Well, both of those things are true. No matter what happens, I know you will be a part of it. Oh, of course. Oh, more? You've never... I don't know quite what to say. With everything my head has been through, I hadn't even considered that you'd even think I was dating material. I come with my own set of matched luggage, if you know what I mean. Is it too sappy to say that you've got my head spinning? But in a good way. I've been through so much, and I finally have a fresh start. I'm just happy that you're gonna be a part of that. Hey, you're back. So, we've been through so much, haven't we? Same thing we do every day, my love. Enjoy ourselves. I think we'll figure it out as we go. We'll make the best of it. No. We did it. Together. We're a team. I don't believe in fate. It's just cheesy, but I think about how we ended up together, and it boggles the mind. I mean, I could have died in space, in my pod. I could have died on impact in the crash. Like my crew, I could have been shredded by mutants or drowned in that old bunker. I could have died from the headaches alone, but instead of any of those potentially more likely scenarios, I was found by somebody. Somebody decent and kind. Someone who cares. Oh. You know I feel the same. I love what we have together, and wouldn't change a thing. USSA, Athena, the crushing headaches. I'd do it all again, as long as I knew it led to you. But it worries me that you're asking. Was there something that you wanted to talk about? I love it. I hope you know that. The fact that you're asking kind of scares me, though. Is there something I should be concerned about? Oh. Somehow, I knew this was coming. Call it waiting for the other shoe to drop. You know, I'll always appreciate everything you've done for me. And thanks to you, I know there's still hope in this world. I know that sounds cheesy or something, but what I'm trying to say is, even if we're not together, you still mean a lot to me. I have every intention of sticking around as a friend, if you'll let me. Now, let's get on with our lives before I take this sappiness to the next level. Oh. What? I mean, that's the last thing I expected you to say. Why the change of heart? Oh, it's so good to hear you say that. I admit, I was pretty crushed to lose you. But oddly, I think the space apart did us both some good. It made me realize that I'm not relying on you. And I've really had the chance to regain my identity again. I'm glad you changed your mind. I think we can give it a real shot this time. That said, anything else you wanted to talk about? Oh. Oh. Well, there's a lot. If it means any. Oh. Sure. I understand. I often thought about that myself. The timing of it all. I had my own fears that we may have rushed into things initially. So, I understood when you ended things. I'm glad you changed your mind. I think we can give it a real shot this time. That said... Oh. Of course, I kept telling it to shut up. But sometimes... Sometimes I should really learn to listen. If it means anything, you'll always have a special place in my heart. And after all you've done for me, I wouldn't have it any other way. Oh. I admit, I've been hoping you'd say something like that. But... Forgiven completely. We'll just call that last time, but that said... Oh. You know, all I know... I have... No. Affirmative.
I just can't shake these nightmares. Floating in space forever. Just... why?
Hey, you. Must be my lucky day. There's something potentially...